You must set up a development machine for Dynamics 365 for operations. On the development machine, you will use Visual Studio to install application updates and write custom code. You will then add the updates and custom code to version control supported by Visual Studio Team Services to ensure that the environments are consistent. Connect to your development virtual machine, also known as a VM, using a remote desktop protocol connection or an RDP. The RDP file and password are available from the Lifecycle Services, also known as LCS, environment page. On your development VM, make sure that you run Visual Studio as an administrator. To save time, pin the Visual Studio shortcut to the Windows taskbar and update the shortcut to run as an administrator. To enter your Visual Studio license, click Sign In. You can sign in with any Microsoft account or organizational account and be granted a temporary Visual Studio license. Sign in with the credentials that you use to access your Visual Studio license. Your Visual Studio personalizations will also be associated with the credential connected to your Visual Studio license. If the credentials that you use to access Visual Studio Team Services, also known as VSTS, is different than the credential for your Visual Studio license, click Add an Account. Sign in with the credentials that you will use to access VSTS. The accounts that you entered will be listed under All Accounts. Enter the credentials for any other accounts that you will need, and then click Close. The Account Settings page is where you can add new accounts or validate the credentials for existing accounts. You can access the Account Settings page at any time by clicking on your name in the upper right corner, and then choosing Account Settings. Open Team Explorer from the View menu. Team Explorer is used to manage the connection to version control from Visual Studio. In Team Explorer, under Hosted Service Providers, click Connect. This will give you access to version control. In the list, select the Team Foundation server that you want to use. If a Team Foundation server isn't listed, you can go back to the Account Settings page and enter the credentials needed to access it. After selecting the Team Foundation server, select the Team Project Collection and Team Project that you want to use. Click Connect to finish connecting to the Team Project. Next, you must map the VSTS project to the local computer. In Team Explorer, click Home, and then click Source Control Explorer. In Source Control Explorer, open the Workspace drop-down list, and then click Workspaces. A workspace is automatically created. In Manage Workspaces, click Edit. The Edit Workspace window is where the VSTS folders are mapped to the local computer. We'll map two folders for Dynamics 365 for operations. The first contains the X++ source code, and the second contains the Visual Studio projects. These are in separate folders because the Visual Studio projects are only needed on the development machines. The build machine only uses the X++ source code. Select the Source Control folder field, and then click the ellipsis button, three dots, to select the path for the X++ source code in the VSTS project. The Source Control folder is the location of the files in the VSTS project. Use the Browse for Folder window to navigate to the path for the X++ source code in the VSTS project. Click OK. The path will end with the metadata folder. The metadata folder is the root of the X++ source code in the VSTS project and is used in both the development and build machines. Select the local folder field and then click the ellipsis button, the three dots, to select the path to the Dynamics 365 for Operations Packages folder on the local computer. Use the Browse for Folder window to navigate to the Dynamics 365 for Operations Packages folder on the local computer. Click OK. The Dynamics 365 for Operations Packages folder is located in the j:\aos-service/packages-local-directory folder on an Azure VM, and in the c:\aos-service/packages-local-directory folder on a downloaded VHD. Select the Source Control folder field, and then click the ellipsis button, the three dots, to select the path for the X++ projects in the VSTS project. The Source Control folder is in the location of the files in the VSTS project and only used on development machines. Use the Browse for Folder window to navigate to the folder for the X++ projects in the VSTS project. Click OK. The path will end with the Projects folder. The X++ projects are used during Visual Studio development. Select Local Folder field, and then click the ellipsis button, the three dots, to select the path to the X++ projects folder on the local computer. Use the Browse for Folder window to navigate to the Visual Studio Projects folder on the local computer. Click OK. The Visual Studio Projects folder is located in this PC/documents/Visual Studio 2015/projects folder. Click OK to complete the mapping from the VSTS project to the local computer. Click Yes to copy the files from the VSTS project to the local computer. This process will take a few minutes to complete. Close the Manage Workspaces window to complete the mapping. You can now use Visual Studio for Dynamics 365 for Operations development. This brings us to the end of this presentation. We hope you found the information useful. Thank you for watching.